Welcome to three-tier application deployment with EKS, CloudFormation, Prometheus, and Grafana. This is as usual Maksud. I am projecting or creating the contents, whichever I have worked or working still. Just the real demo I'm doing. Nothing fairy, nothing exaggeration. Because you guys have to get the job first. So I'm taking from the layman to the expert level. And lots of interview questions, answers I'm giving here. So if you like, then please consider for a subscription. Thank you. And see the project roadmap. Already, if you missed my earlier one, please go to my channel, YouTube one, and then please see my earlier. You can see easily from there. And here, it was my last screen for the earlier part. Now I'll install MySQL using Helm, then mount EBS volume. Also, I'll install the Helm here. Then I'll configure MySQL database here. So let's see if I have the time, then I'll go through some more also. Actually, I'm creating the content at the night time, whole day working, then creating the content night time. So I don't know how much time I need to do that. Please consider it. Thank you. Now this is my pods are running kube system. Then I have to create MySQL database first. Database I'm creating MySQL, and I'm inserting the following config. So like this config, I'm changing this one, like I'm giving my name here as usual, 2024, like that. And database, I'm giving the, actually this is the three-tier application, three-tier, so also three-tier users, making life easier. And password, secret pass, or just giving the same password as this, 2024, that's good for me. Okay, colon WQ, it's done. Now I have to install MySQL in the MySQL namespace with the MySQL hyphen below YAML. Let's see here, ls MySQL values.yaml has been created. Let's see here, cat, I've inserted this one, root password, create database, yes, true, database name, username, password, everything is good, yes. Now I have to see the pods in the MySQL namespace. MySQL namespace. MySQL namespace. Okay. kubectl get namespace. Default. Okay. Create namespace. I have to do first, the namespace should be created. It's now created the namespace. Get namespace. Okay, the MySQL namespace has been created. So I have to get the MySQL pods. Yes. MySQL. It's still not ready, I think. Expected one, but not still ready. It will be ready for initializing. See, first time it was 0/1. Now it's working status. We have to give some time. Oh, it's running now. The status is running, but it's still here showing 0/1. But we can use it, I think. We can use it pod running is the very important. Get inside the MySQL pod. Inside means exec command. Kubectl exec hyphen n MySQL hyphen interactive mode MySQL hyphen 0 bash. So it's deprecated. Let's see. Okay, we are now inside. So I have to go to MySQL output root hyphen p. Yes, password. Azizul 2024. Yeah, it's good now. It's working good. So show databases. First of all, we have to see the databases always. See our three tier is here. So use these three tier databases. Three tier database. Database is changed. So after using this database, I have to create the table. So I'm creating user and history table. These two tables I'm creating. I have taken bunch of commands, guys. I have explained these guys in my earlier videos. You can see. Show tables. Yes, I have created one is user, another is history. See, history and user has come. History has come first because H is earlier than U, right? So history has come first. It's good. Now I have to insert into users something. Like I'm inserting email, password, and their values like that. Then just SQL query select star means all from users. Okay, SQL also working here. So ID, email, then password, then email is first one's email is hello example.com. Password like hello, I have given this one there, inserted there. You can see the password. Yes, I've given this password here. So this password also showing hello. This email is here. This email also showing hello. So it's working nice. Now I have to exit from here. From MySQL also exit from the root user. I've exited. So I have to clone first, git clone. Three-tier application. My repo is here. Three-tier application is here. I have to clone the HTTPS from here. It has cloned. This three-tier app has come. So CD. Three-tier ls. It has frontend and backend. Also readme file. Now I have to go to backend because I have to already have created MySQL. You guys, if missed, then please go my to the earlier video. So MySQL database has been created. Now I'm going to backend. Backend has app.py requirements.txt. Let's see. Cat first requirement.txt. I have here flask MySQL DB flask course. And let's see. App.py has the Python lots of commands here already. Reverse search, summation. So login, everything in the app.py. Yes, backend is ready. ls minus a, the hidden file I have, .env. .env is here. I have to edit this one, vim.env. Insert. So it should be like, actually I'm making life easier. I'm copying from here because it's case sensitive, everything. So name is changed. It should be three-tier user. Password I have used like 2024. Then it should be also three-tier database. So everything looks good. Okay. Now I have to install docker.io. After editing the environment, backend environment, now I have to install Docker. Docker.io is coming. It's working. Okay. Now I have to edit Docker file. Docker file, insert, just I am copy that, insert it. It's from, remember, these are case sensitive, from Python 3.8.7 I'm using, workdir app, or I can use the Python, latest Python also. Let's see the Python. Which one is the latest? Latest stable Python version. One second. 3.8 is showing. It's showing 3.12, right? Stable release of Python. Okay, we are good. Also 3.12.0. Why not latest one? 3.12.0. This is stable. Okay, we are good. Also, okay, then run apt get update. Okay, it's normal. Then install Python pip. Okay. Then copy requirements.txt, then pip install hyphen r recursively requirement.txt, add everything, expose 5000 cmd flask run host 0000. Okay, that's good. Wq. Okay, now I have to build backend Docker image. I'm creating Docker image. Sudo docker build hyphen t, then this is my Dockerhub account name as usual to go. Then I have given that here n tier, or I can give the three tier backend, then version colon version one, then space dot. This dot means everything here in this backend folder, backend location here, everything should be mounted here. Okay. Steam Buster did not found. Okay, then have to go back to earlier one, insert 3.8.7. okay, let's see here. Yes, it's now creating, and my Docker, I have to go to Dockerhub. This is the little to go. So here is two repositories, and now I'm getting one more. So first I'm building, then I'll push. It's taking a bit time. Collecting lots of things. Some are deprecated. Building wheel, yes, successfully done. Yes, successfully. It's tagged and created three tiers. Okay. Now I have to push this one. Push. Docker push is denied. Oh, before push, actually, before push, I have to sign in there first. I have to log in there. Sudo Docker login, username azizul2go, my password. Yeah, it succeeded login. Okay, now I can push. See, I forgot to login. Oh my goodness, nighttime. Feeling sleepy. So it's mounted from library, everything is pushing. See the pushing, how many megabytes? It should be 394 383 393. Oh, 400. Wow, almost. Yeah, it's showing it has been pushed. It's still not, because I have to do refresh, reload. Still here is two, right? Reloading. See the magic? One more. Three tier backend has come. See the version 1. Tag version 1. Three tier tag version 1 is here. This is the backend version. 1 is here. So how to build Docker file, how to push Docker file. You guys got the real-time demo here. Now I'm creating for the same in the front end. CD, go to CD dash, then go to front end. Okay. How many files are there? Default conf, package log, JSON, package JSON. Public src yarn log. So these guys are in the front end, but I need the Docker file. Backend also one Docker file, front end also one Docker file. So I'm dockerizing everything. The latest technology Docker file should be here. Insert, I'm inserting these guys. node from node alpine as build stress, run apk add update python make. Okay, it will copy the package, everything, run npm install yarn build from nginx latest. So nginx I'm using here, and remove this location HTML should be removed. Then I'll create also the HTML, because the older HTML should be removed first, then should be the new one. Then copy from build status, which one build status here, everything should be copy in the src build, also user share nginx HTML copy, it should be copied in my new location also. Then copy default.conf, then this is the new location, expose ID, everything looks good, sounds good. Now how many, let's see, I have added Docker file here, right? So I have to edit this one, beam default.conf, configuration should be edited. Configuration default.conf configuration has server, how can listen, ID, location, root, nginx HTML, but I have to change here location server proxy pass. With proxy pass, front end is talking with backend. So proxy pass section, I have to add backend SBC service 5000 backend hyphen SBC, then 5000. Same way summation. Summation same way. Backend SBC 5000. And I have to create two more. So I just copying from here. Here is reverse and summation. I have to create also login. Just changing the name. It should be login. And it should be get history. I'll see the history. So looks good everything. WQ. Okay, default configuration has been changed and proxy pass also changed. Now I have to see the hidden folder. It has the .env. .env has backend also environment. Beam.env. I have to make it open for all the IP URL. So it should be actually just from equal, it should be everything clean. Okay, it's open for all. It's blank. Now I have to build Docker file to push in a Docker hub. So I'm giving this name like earlier, three tier sudo docker build hyphen t means tag, my account as usual to go, the tag is three tier frontend version one I'm giving, and everything from here. Okay, is it built or not? After building I have to push. This is still working. Npm run install. Okay, running. It's trying automatically is good, because npm has the something older version I think, but it's giving the newer version also. Okay, It's working good, I think. Still looks good. This warning is nothing. Just showing up. Maybe very much busy, the server. Midnight sometimes it becomes busy. And so this is today Friday night. So it should be busy sometimes for deployment, I think. So good thing is that it's creating optimized production build. Production build is getting. So also it has taken almost done, I think. Oh, successfully built. Build number tagged, everything is good. Now I have to push, so just change the tag and build push. Sudo docker push to the location, my docker hub. See, nginx library, everything mounted here, it's pushed. Yes, also has given the number or ID. So if I go there, it will be one more repository. See, three-tier frontend. Earlier was backend, frontend, version 1. So total earlier was 2 and here is 2, 3-tier frontend and backend. That's good. Okay, now I have to create the namespace. Kubectl create namespace. I'm creating like 3-tier. Created. I have to go to the home directory. Okay. Now I have to create backend deployment file. Okay, I'm copying then editing. Okay, so backend deployment file. I have to change something. It was 3-tier backend. Okay. Kubectl create deployment backend, an image from my Docker Hub. It will pull from Docker Hub. Output YAML, dry run client, namespace. Namespace should be 3-tier because I've created the 3-tier. Port 5000, and the name I'm giving backend.yaml, it should be stored there. You can see the 3-tier namespace I've created there, so it should be also here like that. Let's see, it's created. ls, yes, backend.yaml is created. Let's see, cat, yeah, image, azure to go, 3-tier, backend version 1 is created. Everything looks good. Now I have to apply. After creation the backend, I have to apply. So how to apply? Kubectl apply. Remember apply, when apply writing then hyphen f, the function has to become backend.yaml is apply, means it's deployed. Okay, backend is deployed now. Manager sometimes asking deploy the backend. So you have to do like this, kubectl apply hyphen f then backend. Also the dev guy is sometimes asking for deployment because deployment is done mostly by the DevOps guys. Okay, so you must have to know this also interview question, how to deploy backend.yaml, how to deploy kubectl apply hyphen f. Okay, this line hyphen f, just remember. Okay, I have to see now. Kubectl get ports hyphen n, then namespace is 3-tier, right? I've given the 3-tier. Okay guys, it's taking some time. Yeah, crashed loop backup. It's taking some time. It's midnight now, so I'm coming, taking a break now. Thank you.